Hi, I'm Vikash Shah. This is a 40-year-old woman who presented with a 2-day history of abdominal pain. She was found to be tender across the lower abdomen with a vague fullness. You can pause this video if you want to look at the case in quiz mode on Radiopedia. Either follow the link on the screen or from the video description. On the X-ray, there is a loop of bowel filled with gas in the centre of the abdomen, slightly to the left of the midline. There is a house draw fold here across the bottom of the loop, suggesting it is a large bowel loop. There isn't much gas in the rest of the large bowel. There are some gasful loops of small bowel here in the right iliac fossa. This is suggestive of a cecal volvulus, with this gasful loop of large bowel being the twisted and rotated cecum, which has become displaced from the right iliac fossa. Let's take a look at the CT. This is a contrast-enhanced CT in the portal venous phase. You can see that the cecal pole lies up here in the right upper quadrant of the abdomen. And lower down, we can see arising from here a twist in the bowel, the mesentery, and the associated vessels, leading to the distal ascending and transverse colon. The coronal images also show these features. Here you can see the cecal pole up in the right side, just underneath the liver, and then the cecum leading to the ascending colon, which is collapsed. Gas has refluxed from the cecum through the ileocecal valve into distal small bowel loops, and this has the effect of decompressing the cecum. If you follow the bowel, you can again see the twist of the bowel, the mesentery, and the associated vessels. This is known as the whirl sign. There is also a small volume of free fluid between the bowel loops. The cecum has rotated and twisted as it has an unusually large mesentery, which makes it more mobile than usual. It normally resides in the right iliac fossa, but this location is now filled with small bowel loops. There are several take-home messages from this case. When a single large gas-filled viscus is seen, its origin can be determined by the following steps. Look for bowel folds. If there are haustra, this confirms it is large bowel. Alternatively, you may see rugae, which indicates that it is stomach, and these are much more closely spaced than haustra. Look at the shape. Is it coffee bean shaped with a crease in the centre? This is suggestive of it being either a cecal or sigmoid volvulus. Where is the base of the viscus? Is it coming from the pelvis or the right side of the abdomen? If the pelvis, this suggests a sigmoid volvulus, and if right lateral or right iliac fossa, this suggests a cecal volvulus. On the CT, look for the cecal pole, which will not be in the right iliac fossa in a volvulus. Follow the cecum and look for a twist, known as the whirl sign, in the bowel, the mesentery, and the vessels. A complication of cecal volvulus, not seen in this case, is ischemia, which may lead to poor enhancement and gas in the cecal wall. If you want to see more examples of acute abdominal imaging like this, why not come to our abdominal emergency radiology course in Leicester, in the United Kingdom, on Saturday, 14th October. Or, if you can't make it to Leicester, or are watching this after 14th October, you can sign up for the videos to the whole course. Just follow the links on the screen.